I did something crazy. I had a baby and then immediately started a business. Most people find it difficult enough to just have a baby without starting a business at the same time. I have never been one of these people who makes life really easy for myself. I just seem to take on another challenge. That is just the way I seem to do things for some reason. So why did I do that? Why did I have a baby and then start a business? And this was my very first business that I'd ever started as well. I had never started a business before that. I'd had a bit of a practice with blogging before. I'd set up a couple of blogs, but I never really saw them as businesses. I just saw them as like a fun hobby that I just kind of recorded, like a diary of my events. So I'd never really had any experience in business whatsoever. But why did I decide to do this? Well, I was always so used to earning my own money. I'd always earned money. I'd always worked. But the plan was that when we had children, that I would be the stay-at-home mum. I would look after our children full-time and that I wouldn't work. That was the plan. And it sounded really good to me. That's what I thought I wanted. And then I had a baby. And I did really enjoy it. I enjoyed going to baby groups. I read all the baby books. I learned everything I could about babies. And then I just got an overload of babies. Like when you go to these baby groups and they say, oh, hello, what's your baby's name? Is your baby sleeping? Is your baby feeding okay? What's your baby doing with this? What's your baby doing with that? And you just talk about the baby all the time. And then you don't even exist. Nobody knows your name. They only know your baby's name. So you just feel like you don't even exist anymore. It's just all about the baby. And I suppose it should be because it's a really big thing and everything. But after a couple of months of this, my brain did start to get really bored of just talking about babies. And I really wanted to achieve something. I'm a natural achiever. If you look at the Enneagram personality quizzes, then I am number 3, which is called the achiever. So it does make sense that that's what I would struggle with, is not actually achieving anything. And yes, it's an achievement to raise a baby, but you don't get like any sense of, oh, I'm doing this right. Nobody gives you a pat on the back saying, oh, well, your baby's still alive. You must be doing this right. You know, it's just, you don't really get that sense of achievement. So I really felt like I needed to use my brain. I needed to achieve something. I needed to contribute to society and really provide help to people. And I know raising a baby is contributing to society, but that's just how my brain felt at the time. Everyone's different, but that's just personally how I felt. And I just really wanted some mind stimulation. So I decided to set up a business. And I decided that I was going to set up a blog all about smoothies, because I had had a massive transformation myself. I had lost 56 pounds, dropped 5 dress sizes, and I'd lost an incredible amount of weight. So I felt like I had something to give. I had something that I could share with people that would really help them. And I lost the weight by drinking green smoothies. And I invented a very specific formula for a smoothie, which turned a smoothie into a complete meal. So I decided that I had something unique. My USP was my concept for my recipe, and that is what I was going to use to start my blog. And I was going to start being a blogger, and I was going to create a business out of it. And I didn't know exactly how I was going to make money, but I just knew that I was going to do it. So how did I manage to find the time to start a business while I had a newborn baby? So what I did was, and here's the really, really funny thing about this, is that my baby would not go down for a nap in her cot. Whenever I put her down, she would scream and scream and scream. She just hated it. She wanted to be close to me all the time. And it appeared like she never really napped. And funnily enough, she is like this even now, where she just doesn't need much sleep. She's always been like this. She is absolutely bouncing with energy. She's got incredible energy, and she's just never needed much sleep. So from the age of 1, she just didn't nap at all. She never napped again. So I never had like any nap time to even do work. But what she did do was she would have like a little bit of a what I would call like a sleepy feed. So I would feed her myself. So as I was nursing her, she would kind of drift off and then she'd wake up like 2 seconds later and feed and then go back to sleep and then feed. So she would go on like that for about an hour. So every time I fed her, it would take an hour. And I tried all different types of, you know, trying to get out of that cycle and it just wasn't working. So I just went with it and thought, that's how she wants to feed and she wants to be close to me. So fair enough, that's just what I will do. So I bought myself this really cool gadget and I can't remember the name of it now. I'll try and have a look and put a photo of it, but it's like a nursing cushion. It's probably what it's called, a nursing cushion. And it's like a cushion that goes about here and it straps around your back. It clips around your back so you can lie your baby on the cushion and feed the baby without you having to use your hands, which is great, especially if you have the kind of baby that just takes a really long time to nurse and you're getting arm ache and you want to do something else with your hands. You want to maybe use your phone. But what I did was I decided that I was going to start blogging at the same time. So how on earth do you write a blog while you've got a nursing baby attached to you? So what I did was I lay the baby on the nursing cushion. And then I got like a laptop table and I set it out in front of me, in front of the cushion, and pulled that up as close as I could to the cushion. And I put my laptop on top of it. And then I reach my hands over the top and type over the top of the baby nursing. So it was a really strange thing to do. But I did that for, I don't know, a really long time, maybe like even, I mean, at least 6 months. I know she was eating solids, but I did carry on nursing for a really long time. I think maybe like a year and a half, but I think she became faster towards the end. So I had at least 6 months of me blogging like this. Every time she would feed, she would take an hour, and that's the time when I would blog. And I also would do some things in the evening as well. So they are the times when I would work on my blog. And the great thing as well about drinking this green smoothie, these green thickies that I'd invented, was they gave me so much energy because my baby didn't really sleep very well during the night either. So I was quite sleep deprived, but despite the sleep deprivation, these drinks were giving me so much energy that I just felt like my mind was really sharp. It just had so much clarity and I was really excited and passionate about what I was doing. So I had enough energy to be motivated enough to start this business. So what I did was I just started a blog and I started blogging for a few months. And then what I needed to do was work out how am I going to make money from this, because I wasn't really getting much traffic. I was getting little trickles of people coming in, maybe like 30 people a day, and I was promoting it everywhere. So I was, you know, desperately wanting more people to come to my blog and I didn't know how to do it. So then I started to set goals for myself and I started to set plans for my business. And this is the point where things really took off for me, because I would read a goal statement out loud twice a day. And this was a statement that said how much revenue I wanted to make in the future. And it was a really big amount that I set. I think it was in the millions, and how I wanted to do this. So what I was going to give in return for this. And this, I would read this statement every single day out loud for 6 months. And my husband thought it was hilarious. And he was like, oh yeah, you're working on your hobby again. And there's you reading out your goals again. That's really nice. That's really cute and everything. And then what happened next was absolutely incredible. Within just a few months of starting to do this, my traffic absolutely started soaring, and I think I got just under 100,000 page views a month really, really quickly. It just absolutely flew. And then I started to earn money. I started to put some, first of all, what I did was I put banner ads on my website, so the other people's advertising, because I was getting so much traffic that when you get a lot of traffic to your website, you can put other people's ads, and an ad network will pay you money for that. So I put ads on my website and I started earning money through that. And then I started to get feedback from my readers, and they started asking me for things, and they started asking me for meal plans and diet plans and how did you do it? Where's all your recipes? I want them all. So I created a 7-day detox and I started selling that. And it absolutely took off. It was so popular. People were flooding to buy this product. And what happened was I was selling this one product. I had banner ads on my website, and I also made money through something called affiliate marketing, which is when you have blog posts, you can recommend that people go and buy something from your blog post from another company, and that company will give you a small percentage of the money. So I put affiliate links to Amazon, and I was recommending things like ingredients that people would need to make their smoothies, like seeds and nuts and dates and that kind of thing, and maybe some green powders for the green smoothies. And then people were clicking on those links, going over to Amazon, buying the product or a different product that when they were on Amazon, because you get a commission for whatever product people buy on Amazon, not just the one that you have linked to. So people were buying things on Amazon, and I was getting a really good commission because I had such high traffic. Then a lot of people were clicking the links, and I was making a lot of money through that. So within just a few months, my revenue was actually at the six-figure mark, and I was blown away. I could not believe that my little blog that I just started a few months ago could make this much impact, reach this many people, and make this much money. It was incredible, the change in our lifestyle, because remember, I wasn't earning any money. I'd never set up a business before. We were living solely on my husband's income, and we had just bought our first house, so money was really tight. We couldn't afford to go on holiday, on vacation. I was buying second-hand clothes for my children, for my baby, bundles of used clothing. We didn't have any money for any luxuries at all. I didn't buy myself new clothes, nothing like that. There was no luxuries. We never went out to restaurants or anything like that. And then all of a sudden, I've got a six-figure income, and I was getting to keep almost all of it because my expenses were really low. I wasn't really paying for very much. When you sell digital products, you make a really high percentage of profit. So my profit levels are really high, so I was getting to keep almost all that money. And the change that it made in our lifestyle was incredible. I could buy new clothes for my baby. We could go abroad. Like, we went to Greece for the first time and got some sunshine because we were living in a very cold place in Scotland at the time. And it was freezing half of the year. I was always walking around in my snow boots. So just to be able to go on holiday and get some sunshine was incredible. And it just made such a massive change in my life. So I just wanted to make this video to inspire you that if you have a baby, or if you're thinking about having a baby, you don't need to put off starting a business, because it can be easier than you think. And if you are, the most important thing about starting a business is just the decision to do it and the determination that you are going to make it work no matter what. And it doesn't mean to say that you have to neglect your family because you've started a business. Like, I still spent time at the weekends with my family when my husband was off work. We still went on trips the whole weekend. I didn't work the whole weekend during the day, but I just did work in the evening during the week and when my baby was feeding. So I still had a balanced life. Yes, I did sacrifice watching TV, but to me that wasn't a big sacrifice because I found it really boring anyway. And like I said, I'm that kind of personality where I need to achieve things. So yes, you need to make some sacrifices, but you don't need to sacrifice absolutely everything. All you need is determination that yes, I'm going to have it all. I'm going to have a balanced family life, and I'm going to find little slots of time in my day that I might have wasted time on social media or watching TV or reading magazines or whatever it is that you do to waste away time. And you'd be surprised at where you actually waste this time. And what could you do instead? Like, even if you don't want to have a setup like me where you're actually able to use a computer, maybe you could use your smartphone. You could record like a video of yourself while you're sitting there feeding your baby, and you could put it in such a place that nobody even knows that your baby's there. Or you could, so people don't actually need to see that you're holding your baby at the same time. There's so many different things that you can do while you've got a baby. So many people start vlogs where they include their baby in their vlog, and they're showing other people how they manage to work a business and look after their baby at the same time, or they just make looking after their baby the purpose of their video. Like if you set up a blog or a vlog about how to feed your baby healthy food, and you had your recipes about the healthy ingredients that you were putting into your baby food and how you were storing it, preparing it, what containers you were going to use. There's so many ways that you can incorporate a baby into a business. So just have a brainstorm, sit down and just have a think of ways that you can actually create a business at the same time as you've got a baby. And the same applies to having young kids. It does feel like it is really difficult to start a business or continue with a business while you've got a baby or young children. But it is possible, as long as you keep your mindset in the right place that yes, I can do it, and then you will definitely be able to do it. So I hope that's given you some encouragement. Let me know in the comments, have you got a baby? Do you have young children? Are you thinking about having a baby? Has this given you some kind of motivation that you can do it even with a baby? Just let me know. And I create a lot of videos helping people with their mindset, helping entrepreneurs to get their mindset in the right place, to set goals, to plan their business. These are the kind of videos that I like to create. So if this sounds like something that you're interested in, I would love it if you would subscribe and hit that notification bell so you actually get notified when I publish a new video. And I can't wait to share my next video with you. My last video was all about how to actually decide your goals. So go and check that out if you are struggling with what goals to set. And I will see you next time with some great content. Take care.